the Tom Likas Show.
Gotta show my brothers lifestyle I have here in L.A. I mean, I could do this. I could do this, yeah, come on.
And now, here he is, Tom Likas.
Thank you for tuning in to the Tom Likas Show and returning to the Tom Likas Show for this hour. Is our old friend Mr. Skin. Hey, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, long time no nudity.
Absolutely. It's been quite a while. I meant to ask you, with the reference to you in the movie Knocked Up, did you get any cashola for that or just some free publicity?
It was free publicity, but that free publicity obviously has been very good for our business since the movie came out in June of 2007.
I imagine there were many references to your website just in movie reviews alone.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's tons of them. There were so many links back to our website when people were reviewing that movie. And you got to remember, when something like that happens, it comes out in theaters. Then, a few months later, it comes out on DVD. And then a few months after that, you could start to watch it on cable TV, and you still can see it on cable TV. So it's like a nonstop free promotion. And one of the other things is it was a really fun, cool movie that almost every guy I know has seen, and most of them enjoyed. So you can't ask for better free publicity.
Now, did they contact you when they were writing the script for Knocked Up? Or?
Yes, the summer before the attorneys at Universal contacted me and said that, you know, the guy that did The 40-Year-Old Virgin, his next movie, he wanted to, you know, put MrSkin.com in the movie. And, I didn't even think for a second I wasn't going to charge him or anything. I just said, yeah, I'd love to do it. And I was very cooperative and hoping that it would be a nice reference. And to be honest, I couldn't have asked for a better way to write us into the script. I think that the only product placement I've ever seen in a movie better than Mr. Skin and Knocked Up was Reese's Pieces in E.T.
So was it exciting when you went to see the film? Did you see an advanced screening? What was it like to see your website there in the film?
A huge thrill. In fact, I was able to get a ticket to the premiere, which was a very hard ticket to get. And I was able to go there with my wife and sitting there, and there were tons of huge celebrities. I'm from Chicago. I'm not like you guys around the celebrities all the time. And I was in the, in a theater, and so many big names were there. And to see, not only did they show the website, they based what Seth Rogen was doing for a living directly on what I do for a living. And it was really a neat thing. The whole experience was great. It was just a fun, fun thing that year.
Now, of course, you're around the big celebrity of the day, the governor of Illinois. Come on.
Yeah, we're really proud here. Big big day. They're calling it Crook County instead of Cook County.
So. I thought all that stuff ended with the first Mayor Daley. I thought that was supposed to be over.
No, it's always been a corrupt city. What are you going to do?
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
But we're not here to talk about that. We're here to talk about you. And we're here to talk about what you say are the 20, and these are, of course, who else is doing this. So when I say what you say are the top 20 nude scenes in 2008, who else has a list like this? Does anybody else have a list like this?
No, they really don't. There's a few websites here and there that try, but I think that after doing this now for 9 years, people refer to our list as kind of the number one list when it comes to female nudity in film. And actually, what I do every year is put together a top 20 nude scenes list for the year. But this year, I added a special bonus at the top 10 TV nude scenes, because what's really been cool, Tom, over the last couple of years is the best nudity right now is not coming from the theater. It's not coming from DVD extras. It's coming from the cable TV series that you're seeing on HBO and Showtime and even now on the Starz Network. All the good nudity, or I should say the best nudity, are coming from these shows like The L Word or True Blood or Entourage and Weeds, and the list goes on and on. And I had to make a special list this year for the top 10 TV nude scenes on top of the top 20 movie nude scenes.
Well, I think it makes sense that the best nude scenes would be coming from television, because that's where you can use those scenes.
Right, exactly. And what's cool, I think, though, is there's been kind of like a competition among all these shows. It just seems that they're great shows. I mean, you watch Californication. It's a very well-written, funny show. But they put in incredibly great sex scenes and hot chicks naked. And what that does is, maybe if you're on the fence or you're thinking, gee, I only have so much time in the day or the week to pick some shows. Well, heck, I'll watch the shows with the great nudity on top of the good entertainment. So it seems like all these shows have some element of nudity, some off the charts great nudity, and in the end, we all win.
Now, how does Mrs. Skin feel about all of this?
Luckily, Mrs. Skin is very cool with what I do for a living. In fact, Tom, I could never be married to someone who had a problem with what I do. It would never have worked out. I mean, heck, I get to go to the Playboy Mansion. I'm going to the porn convention next month. I'm looking at naked chicks every day. I go into the office, got to be in by 10:30 because we're having a meeting on lesbian scenes. So I can't have an uptight wife.
I understand all that, but you just have to wonder. And another question I have for you is, has there been any interest in doing a gay version of Mr. Skin, like Mr. Foreskin, for example?
Yeah. Nah, you know what? There's just right now I love this job too much. If I have to start looking at nude guy butt, it's just this won't be fun. It'll be work.
I completely understand.
Yeah.
All right, let's talk about some of these nude scenes.
Maybe I was thinking I could maybe go over the top 10 movie nudes and then maybe do some of the TV nudes for you as a bonus too, and get right to the good stuff for you.
Bonus with a capital B. All right, go right ahead.
Yeah, but as far as my movie nude scenes go, my movie nude scenes, coming in at number 10 is Angelina Jolie in a movie called Wanted, which came out on DVD last week. She's getting out of a tub or out of the water, and you could see her butt. There's a pretty wild tattoo she has on there, but you get a great shot of her butt. I have to got to give props to Angelina Jolie. She's a huge Hollywood star, A-list actress, and this is her 13th film she's been naked, and though it was only a butt shot, she has such an incredible backside that it definitely came in at number 10 on my best news scenes list. Number 9, Penelope Cruz did a movie called Elegy, and Tom, I want to mention, you and the guys probably don't know half these movies because these are, you know, art house films and chick flicks and stuff, but don't worry about it, because really it's my job to find these movies and just tell you guys about the news scenes.
So you do all the hard work.
Yeah, the heavy lifting, right. But anyway, well, Penelope Cruz, she's number 9 on my list of best movie nude scenes. She would have been higher, but she was having sex with Ben Kingsley, Gandhi,
boy.
I had to penalize her a few notches.
That's
there.
A turnoff right there.
Yeah. Number 8 is Mina Suvari, who you guys would probably remember in the movie American Beauty a while back with Kevin Spacey. Well, she's back, and do you remember that case of a girl in Texas a couple years ago who was driving her car, hit a homeless guy, got him in the windshield, and just kind of left the car in the garage for a few days?
Oh, yes, we talked about that.
Yeah, it was a real creepy thing. Well, Stuck is what this movie's about. Mina Suvari plays that girl, and she has an amazing sex scene in it, and that came in at number 8 on my best movie nude scenes of 2008.
Wow. Now, have you watched any of these movies all the way through? I know you tend to fast forward a lot, but...
Yeah, mostly. I want to be honest. I mean, some I've sat through, but most of the stuff I'm going to be talking about... With the movie stuff, I've mostly fast forward through or just focused on the nude scenes, but the TV stuff, a lot of it I've seen because I'm big fans of a lot of these TV shows. So
mm-hmm.
It just depends. I'm not going to sit through a two-hour chick flick, to be honest with you. So.
I completely understand.
Number 7 on the best movie nude scenes of 2008 is Amy Smart in a movie. It's a Kiefer Sutherland movie called Mirrors. You and the guys might remember Amy Smart. She was the hot chick who got naked in Road Trip, the Tom Green movie from a few years back.
Oh, yeah.
And she's really hot. She's getting into a tub here. There's it's a horror movie, so there's a scary incident that happens after her great nudity here, but we won't worry about that. She looked great in the movies called Mirrors for Amy Smart, number 7. Now, number 6 is my only PG-13 movie on the list, and that's Anna Faris in The House Bunny, and she plays a playmate turned sorority babe, and it's a real sexy scene. She's wearing a towel like out of the shower on her head and then a towel around her body. She drops the towel, and it's a backside butt shot, but Anna Faris is the girl who was in all the scary movie films, and she's really smoking hot. She had never been naked, and it was a real nice great scene, and that came in at number 6.
Do we think that's a body double or the real Anna Faris?
It was her. One thing, Tom, I could promise you is when we I would never put a body double in my top list. So we check it out at the Mr. Skin Laboratories. That is
really?
Yeah. Oh,
now,
yeah.
How do you do that?
Well, you make sure you see the face with the body, and you watch the whole scene. And there's ways in Hollywood, you know, obviously body doubles have been going on forever, and you just have to know how to spot them. And we do a lot of work. And in the few instances where we're not 100% sure either way, we'll mention that it's a possible body double. But in this case, it was her.
Very, very nice.
Number five on my best movie nude scene list is Neve Campbell in a movie called I Really Hate My Job. And I have to give her credit for this nude scene because not only was she completely naked while drinking a glass of wine, but she did the scene in a crowded restaurant. So in other words, all those extras sitting at all those tables while they were filming got to see Neve Campbell naked. So a pretty daring scene for someone who's not known for really getting naked. In fact, even in her in the great Menage a Trois scene in Wild Things, she didn't even get naked. Denise Richards did. She only showed her back. So it was really an amazing moment for Neve Campbell. And I Really Hate My Job, which is number five on the list.
Do we know what wine she was drinking in that show?
No, you're the wine expert. You'd probably be able to tell. I was just looking at her breath. So.
I was trying to figure out if that was a Cabernet or Merlot.
Number four on the list of the best movie nude scenes is a girl named Asia Argento, and your audience might know her. The movie's called The Last Mistress, but your audience might know her. She was the hot chick in the Triple X movie with Vin Diesel from a few years back, and she's been naked. She's from Italy. She's been naked in 16 films. Her dad's a director in Italy, and believe it or not, this is how wild this girl is. She's a couple of the movies she's been naked in, her dad actually was the director of the movie, so pretty creepy.
Oh, stuff. Boy.
Yeah.
Wow.
Creepy stuff. Her name's Asia Argento, but she's gorgeous, and the sex scene will blow you away when you look at the pics of that.
Now, are these real boobs here? I have questions.
Now, you know what? You that's a great call. Usually, if you got a European actress, you know, 75% of the time they're real, but I'm going to have to say that she's had a little work done because they're just too firm for the position she's in.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But she is gorgeous. She is gorgeous. Number three on my list of the best movie nude scenes of 2008. Number three is a girl you guys all know, Heather Graham. And, you know, she did the great nude scene in Boogie Nights a few years back. But this sex scene she has in a Drift in Manhattan is pretty wild. I mean, the position she's in, I should say, and she's completely naked during the sex scene. And I will say, Tom, very important for your audience, the unrated version of A Drift in Manhattan has this scene in its entirety. You will get gypped if you don't get the unrated version. So it's very important or you'll miss one of the great nude scenes of 2008.
Oh, wow.
Yes. If you see what she's doing, it's a good scene.
By the way, before we go on, I think you make an interesting point about the rated and unrated versions. Are there retailers that sell edited videos? Didn't years ago, like Walmart, sell edited DVDs because they, you know, there was some religious bent to it.
The movie companies went after them and they put the kibosh on that because you can't mess with someone's copywritten product.
Oh,
like that.
Really? So if you go to Walmart, you'd be able to pick up director's cut?
What happened is, and I'm not positive because you know, I don't shop at Walmart or buy my movies there, but what they'll do is some stores, and I can't say which for sure, some stores would only sell maybe an R-rated version. They wouldn't sell an NC-17 or an unrated. So it just depends on the store.
Yeah. I bought a copy of a movie at Costco a few years ago. Now, it may have just accidentally fallen into the bin, but this was a Martin Scorsese film that was, it was sanitized within an inch of its life.
Oh, yeah. Well, then that's not good because I don't think that's right for anyone to edit other people's work like that, so, especially getting rid of nudity. That's terrible.
Absolutely.
So anyway, we're down to the end here. Number two on my best movie nude scenes of 2008. Number two is a girl named Sophie Monk in a movie called Sex and Death 101. Now, she's been in the news lately because Paris Hilton's was dating Benji Madden from the band Good Charlotte, and I guess Benji Madden and her used to be an item. And she's from Australia. She looks like a modern-day Brigitte Bardot. She's ridiculously hot. And people might know her in that Adam Sandler movie, Click, when he was saw the jogger. She was the one, and she's beautiful, and has a completely naked scene in this Sex and Death 101, which I felt was the second best movie nude scene of 2008.
Yeah, she is hot as a pistol. I'm looking at this right now.
Yeah, she's ridiculous. And now number one of all the movie nude scenes I saw, my favorite one was Misha Barton in a movie called Closing the Ring. Now, Misha is known as Marissa on the TV show The OC for many years. This was her nude debut. Tom, I always give a lot of credence when an actress is naked for the first time. That carries a lot of weight. But also, as I've said to you before, it's very important that a good nude scene has good lighting, because what good is a hot babe naked if it's dark and you need a coal miner's hat? So anyway, Misha Barton in Closing the Ring, my favorite nude scene of 2000, as far as movies go.
Well, they may carry a lot of weight that she's appearing in this film, but she's not carrying a lot of weight in the film. I'll tell you that. No. She looks fantastic.
Yeah, she has a great breast, So
look at that.
Yeah, and anyway, so I thought maybe I'd give you some of my five best TV nudes.
I'll tell you what. Here's what we're going to do. We'll take a break. We'll come back.
Great.
We're going to get those. We're going to continue with Mr. Skin. It's MrSkin.com, MrSkin.com. Mr. Skin's website is devoted to finding you breasts in movies. All the great nude scenes of chicks. And Mr. Skin is a human encyclopedia when it comes to nude scenes in movies going back to all time. So if you've got a question for Mr. Skin or you've got a comment about his favorite nude scenes of the year, you can call in right now.
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. The Tom Likas Show.
It's the Tom Likas Show. We are here with Mr. Skin. It's MrSkin.com, without a space, MrSkin.com. And Mr. Skin now is going to give us some of the top TV nude scenes of 2008. Of course, it's cable TV.
Yeah, you're not going to see nudity on 2.5 Men, you know.
And although they come close, I think.
They do. They push the envelope as far as anyone. I got to give those guys credit.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah. No question. But the... like I said, TV nudity is where it's at, and there's so many good shows. I have to say that right now, I think the hottest channel is Showtime, because, you know, they have Californication, Dexter, Weeds, The Tudors, Brotherhood, to name a few. But I gotta say, HBO with this, show True Blood has really got probably the big show of 2008, the breakthrough show of 2008. But like I said, either way, there's so much good nudity on TV. It was hard for me to narrow it down to 10, and I thought maybe I'd go over my top five TV nude scenes.
Sure.
To do that. Well, number five on my list is from Entourage, one of my favorite shows. I was watching this actually when it happened with my wife, and it was when the rapper Bow Wow has a character where he's playing an up-and-coming actor in a Kevin Connolly is representing him, and Bow Wow is in bed, and Kevin Connolly calls him, and he picks up the phone, and he's having sex with this incredibly gorgeous woman. And I was saying to my wife, I know that girl. I met her somewhere. Where do I know her from? And it turns out it's Genevieve Jolie, who's a real-life porn star, doing the thing. So that wasn't a good... That was one I probably should have kept to myself. But I met her at a show or something. I was like, I know that girl. And I'm like, oh, great, it's a porn star. But she actually, the next day, I had so many emails and people, requesting who was the girl on Entourage, and it turned out Genevieve Jolie. So I know a lot of people remember that scene, and it really was a great moment. Number four on my list, there's a new show. I don't know if a lot of people know about it. It's on the Starz network. They're trying to get into this original programming, and it's called Crash. It's based on that movie from a few years back, and Dennis Hopper's really the big star of the show. And there's the girl on it, her name's Arlene Tur, is one of the girls. She, done some stuff on Grey's Anatomy. She used to be, from what I understand, a professional volleyball player turned actress. And all I could say is that when you see her topless, you probably don't know who she is, but just picture if one of those hot beach volleyball players did a topless scene. And
who's looking at her face?
Yeah, she's amazing. I mean, it was just, just a great moment on Crash. And they're doing a great job putting lots of naked chicks on their show so that we'll all watch it. But Arlene Tur and Crash was my fourth favorite TV moment. Now, I mentioned True Blood, and Anna Paquin comes in at number three. And I have to admit, when I was watching the first few episodes of True Blood, there was nudity, but it wasn't from the stars of the show. And I thought to myself, there's no way Anna Paquin's going to do a nude scene. She won an Academy Award when she was younger in The Piano.
When she was 11.
Right, exactly. And she had never done a nude scene, and she's super smoking hot. And I thought, there's no way she's going to get naked. And next thing you know, she's having sex with a vampire. Top comes off, and I have to say it was worth the wait because she really looked great. The buzz on this, I know on the Internet, was crazy. And I wasn't the only guy that loved this nude scene. So Anna Paquin in True Blood was a memorable moment in 2008. So number two on the list of the best TV nude scenes is an old standby, but she looked amazing. Mary Louise Parker from Weeds, and she's 44 years old, and she's playing on this show a mom who sells some drugs in the suburbs. In the first half of the year of Weeds, there really wasn't much nudity, and then boom, in the last few episodes, including this one that I loved where she was in a bathtub completely naked, and for 44, her dime bag still looked amazing. So I got to say that Mary Louise Parker in Weeds, even at 44, was an amazing moment. That came in at number two for my TV nude scenes. And finally, at number one, this is also from True Blood, and anyone who's watched the show knows exactly what I'm talking about. Lizzie Kaplan, who, if you don't know her by name, she was the star of the movie Cloverfield. She was in Mean Girls. She was on a TV show called The Class, and she is gorgeous. And I hate to throw around the word perfect as far as breasts are concerned, but her first topless scene on True Blood just was crazy. And I, like I said, I know I wasn't the only guy that loved this scene. And I have to say, Tom, movie or TV, this was my favorite nude scene of 2008.
Wow. Fantastic. Yeah. Let's take some calls here. We got Mr. Skin.
Sure.
We'll take calls coming up here at 1-800-5800-TOM. It's 1-800-5800-866. Mr. Skin is the world's foremost expert on nudity in films involving chicks. He knows, and by the way, you can go back 10, 20, 30 years. He knows them all. How far back? What's the oldest movie you know about, by the way?
Well, I mean, there was some silent era stuff, but that isn't easy to find at your local video store. I think probably one of the oldest that goes back that you could actually rent would be Ecstasy from 1932, where Hedy Lamarr, who would go on to be in the movie Samson and Delilah,
yes,
when she was older, when she was like 17 or 18 years old, did a this movie Ecstasy, and she's running around naked chasing a horse. It was just before the Hays Commission kicked in and pretty much got all skin out of any movies for about 20 years. And she was 18, or like I said, about 18, and it's one of the great nude while chasing a horse scenes in movie history. So
wow.
Yeah, it's one of the oldest. But we go back. I mean, we have stuff from the 20s and all that. So
love that.
Yeah.
All right, if you've got a question about female nudity in films, Mr. Skin is the man. All you need to do is call in.
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. The Tom Likas Show.
Tom Likas Show, with less commercials, more phone calls, now heard 6 days a week in Los Angeles, Saturdays 2 to 6, that's right, Tom Likas Show now 6 days a week, on the Tom Likas Show, it's 1-800-5800-TOM, we are here with Mr. Skin, and now... We get into your calls here. 1-800-5800-TOM for Mr. Skin. Albert on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Yes, hello, Tom. I was trying to ask Mr. Skin, is the movie Taking Lives, was that really truly Angelina Jolie, or is that a body double?
In which scene? You mean during the sex scene?
Yes, I was curious about that.
Yeah, no, we went through that movie, and actually you see it's 100% her breasts, but there's even a scene that we found where you see even more than her breasts, and that was a frame-by-frame effort in our skin offices. So, yes, taking lives, the nude scene of Angelina Jolie is 100% real. It is her.
Now, the male actor, who was that? I mean, who was the lucky guy to actually nail Angelina Jolie?
All right, now you're getting into some real obscure stuff, like who the guy is she's having sex with. So.
That's where skin gets off the boat,
yeah,
right there.
I only have so much room in my head, you know?
Well, if Mr. Skin, if you had it your way, would you want to be that guy? I know I would.
Oh, my God, are you kidding me? Yeah, of course, of course.
So would we all.
Yeah, yeah, but it 100% was Angelina Jolie. No fake, no body double.
Jason, you're on with Mr. Skin. Hello.
Hey, Tom Likas, long time, first time.
Thank you.
I had a question for Mr. Skin there. First, I'd like to say thank you for helping me out through my puberty. But I just wanted to think what you thought about Marissa Tomei and Before the Devil Knows You're Dead. We all know we were waiting for it since My Cousin Vinny.
Well, let me tell you, what I thought of it is I voted it the best nude scene of 2007, so you're talking to a huge fan. But I have some good nudes for you. There's a movie called The Wrestler that'll be out in limited release, I think December 21st or right around within the next couple of weeks. It'll be in limited release. It'll be out in wider release after the first of the year. She plays this, first of all, Mickey Rourke, they're talking Oscar nomination for this Wrestler movie. But the real big news as far as skin fans are concerned is Marissa Tomei plays a stripper. And she's up on stage. She's topless. Amazing shots. I love the Before the Devil Knows You're Dead. This is like about a notch below it as far as quality of nudity. Her cousin Vinny's have never looked better. I can't say enough about it. So The Wrestler, check this out. It'll be in theaters in a few weeks and then wider release after the first of the year. So we're going to have two great movies to see Marissa Tomei naked now.
Jason, thank you for the call. It's Jake on the Tom Likas Show for Mr. Skin. Hello.
Hey, Mr. Skin, I think it's ridiculous to put Neve Campbell on that list. I think she looked horrible in that nude. I mean, come on.
Well, I mean, what do you mean horrible? I mean,
I think that maybe if she done that, she'd done that maybe 10 years ago. But, just does not look good anymore.
No, I would definitely not say she doesn't look good. And again, everyone has their own taste. I, to be honest with you, I love nudity in film, but I don't want every nude scene to be a 23-year-old with fake breasts. I appreciate the different looks and the different bodies, and you can argue with that, and I have no problem with it, but for me personally, I really loved it, and don't forget, it wasn't just her breasts you saw, you also saw her butt in that scene, too.
Ray on the Tom Likas Show for Mr. Skin. Hello.
Hey, Tom. Good show.
Thank you.
Long time listener, first time caller.
Long time listener, first time caller.
Hey, I got a curious question in regards to Jane March and The Lover.
Mm-hmm.
I've been wondering, how old was she then? And I hear rumors that was a real thing. That sex scene.
Yeah, you know what? That's pretty funny.
It looks so real. I did the shit on the DVD, and it looks like they really did.
Yeah, you know, that's one of those movies, because I get asked that question a lot. Can you name times in the movies where the actor and the actress were having sex, and then which are the ones where they were really having sex? And my stock answer to that is, well, we can only speculate. And I agree, that was very realistic. It looked like they were having sex, but I'm like you. All I could do is an amazing movie. Unfortunately, that's one where you also see Bruno the Lover is one of the great movies for nudity of the 90s. And she was about, I would say, 18 or 19 when she did that.
But she looked so young in that movie, with The Lover.
Yeah. Well, she was. She was 19.
I just want to make sure she's underage or what, because she didn't have a hot body until she got to Bruce Willis' film, and I think she had it done.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, she was great. It's one of my favorite movies for nudity. You don't have to sell me on it. I love it.
Ray, thank you for the call. Julie, with Mr. Skin on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hi, Mr. Skin.
Hey, Julie.
Wondering what you have for the female listeners, like the top 10 male nude scenes, or
I have a thing. It's called the internet. Just go look around and see what you can find. No, you know what? It's just Mr. Skin. I made the call. There's been many times through the 9 years I've had this website where people have, you know, said to me that, boy, if you just did a website with guys, you could make so much money. And it's just, this job is too much fun. I can't make my life I can't make this work. I just.
By the way, Julie, what would you think of a guy who would know who the hottest guys were naked?
Well, I had more respect for that guy just because, you know, they're willing to actually sit through a movie and see another guy.
But people probably think he was a homo. Not that there's anything wrong with being a homo.
Yeah. But hey, I'm offering out. That's a great business opportunity, so go do it.
Maybe I should. Thank you.
Good luck, Julie. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. Mr. Skin is with us. It's mrskin.com, mrskin.com. Here is Jeff on the Tom Likas show. Hello.
Hello, Tom. Hello, Mr. Skin.
Yo, yes. Jeff.
Hey, first off, I'm so excited to see Misha Barton naked after watching the O in Ohio and being...
That should be illegal, man, because when people... I had a guy at a film fest on the cell phone after he saw it tell me how naked she was, and then we do a frame-by-framer at the Skin offices, and it was just outrage. I mean,
I zoomed in on the DVD player. And
that was bad. That was bad.
Oh, excuse me. So my real question is, going back to when you were talking about your top three films this year, I heard about The Click Girl, and I...
You heard about what?
The girl from Click, the movie Click.
Oh,
and
yeah,
I heard
yeah, yeah.
About
okay.
Misha
Sophie
Monk.
Sophie Monk.
But what was the first movie that you had to watch unrated?
The first movie I saw unrated in my life?
I came in listening a little late, and I wanted the movie you guys were talking about. You'd have
okay, I know what you're saying. Yes, Heather Graham is my third best movie nude scene of 2008. It's called The Drift in Manhattan. Is the movie? She has an incredible sex scene, but you have to get the unrated version. And that's the only one we have at our website. We didn't even bother with the other one. The unrated version has that great sex scene, so you could see that. But you have to get the unrated version.
Thank you, Jeff, for the call. Jose, you're on with Mr. Skin. Hello. Hello. All right, Ryan, you're on with Mr. Skin. Hello.
Hey, Tom. Hey, Mr. Skin.
What up, Ryan?
Hey, quick question, Mr. Skin. Alicia Cuthbert from Girl Next Door?
Yeah.
Is that her name?
Yeah, she's a...
Alicia Cuthbert.
Right. That's
yeah, thank you, thank you.
Yeah, she's a Canadian babe, been in the news of late.
Sloppy Seconds, is that her name for her next movie?
Yeah, her nickname's S Squared. But she, the only movie in that movie, The Girl Next Door, she's in a thong. That we don't at MrSkin.com, we don't count that as nudity, but heck, thong is pretty hot stuff. And that's the best place to see her. Everything else she's done has been a body double. So check out. The Girl Next Door is the best place to see her thong action from Alicia Cuthbert.
Thank you, Ryan. It's Dave on the Tom Likas show for Mr. Skin. Hello.
Hey, Tom. Good to talk to you. And Mr. Skin, it was good to hear your little comment about Marissa Tomei. I'll have to check that out. But
we actually already have the wrestler's not even in theaters yet, and we already have preview new picks. So you got to check that out. That's off the chart.
That ought to be good. I want to ask you a little bit about Alyssa Milano. You know, of course, that was a famous one.
Embrace
Vampire.
Yeah, Embrace of the Vampire. I consider that the Citizen Kane of celeb nude horror movies.
How many scenes was that? Like five or six?
Yeah, it was like exactly. Let's put it this way: in one movie. She had a lesbian scene, a menage a trois scene, and she was pretty much naked throughout. So you can't beat Embrace the Vampire. Yeah. In fact, I think I've done more PR for that movie than any PR company's ever done for any movie in the history of film.
Oh, man. How many minutes was all that?
How many do you need? I've never edited it all up, but I can. But not only is Alyssa Milano naked five different times in that, but there's two or three other girls. I know Glory Gold and Sabrina Allen, to name a few, and they're naked too in those other scenes. So it's a chock full. It's a Mr. Skin Hall of Fame movie. So I can't say enough about it.
Thank you for the call, Dave. Let me say hi here to Leroy on the Tom Likas show for Mr. Skin. Hello.
Yo, Tom.
Yeah.
Mr. Skin.
What up,
good
Leroy?
Good goddamn product. I love it, man. I love it. I got a good nude for you. How about Carla Gugino off Sin City?
Oh, yeah.
In the bathroom.
I love it. It was one of my best nude scenes. I'm trying to think what year that came out. Whatever year Sin City came out, it was like 2005 or 2006. I had it in my best nude scenes of the year. But I recommend you check out a movie she did called Jaded. Pretty wild scene with her and two other girls. I have to admit it's a little rough, not to get into details, but that is another one to check out. But her Sin City nudity is ridiculous, and she's had a cool recurring role on Entourage the last two seasons, and I think she's been great on Entourage. And if you want to see her naked, Sin City and Jaded are the two best places.
Thanks a lot, Leroy, for the call. I appreciate it. All right, Mr. Skin, now, your website is subscription only, is it not? How do people...
No, you could, yeah, you could go to our website, and it's totally free if you just want to use it as a reference, and then yourself go out and rent or buy the movies or just to get the information. Yeah. But the to be a member, it costs $4.95 for 3 days access. I think we're almost at 17,000 actresses chronicling every nude scene they've done. So I don't think it'd be 3 days. You could probably get through one hundredth of the website.
So you've got actual clips or photos?
Oh yeah, we have. We'll take a Marissa Tomei, for example. We'll have every movie she's been naked in. We'll review each movie. We'll review each scene. We'll rate each scene, and then you could see the pictures and the video clips with sound in high def, if possible, of the scene. So it's what we do is fast forward to the nude scenes for you, so you don't have. We even tell you what time it is. So if you want to run to the video store, you could just fast forward your DVD to that scene.
Fantastic! Always good to have you on. The listeners love you, as you know.
Yeah, well, thanks, Tom. I always have a great time on your show. It's a riot. Thanks.
Absolutely. Mr. Skin, go to MrSkin.com. That's M-R Skin without a space. MRSkin.com. Coming up next, we're going to meet the chick in that Carl's Jr. commercial. Stay tuned.
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866. The Tom Likas Show.
Hollywood, it's Tom Likas Show. Thank you for tuning in. I was eating. Sorry, I was like... That happens. Sitting with me is Tamara Brown, and you've seen her on TV because she's in those Carl's Jr. commercials. How's it going?
Hi, Tom. It's doing great. How are you?
Good, good. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
Now, we've seen you a million times in these spots, but for people who don't know which spot we're talking about, tell us the plot of the spot.
Well, it actually came out yesterday, and there's two spots running. One is a 15-second spot where I'm changing, and it's pretty sexy, but, I mean, it's not too scandalous.
It can't be too scandalous because it's a commercial.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
Can't be that scandalous.
And the other commercial is me and my boyfriend. We kind of have a bit of confusion because I think we're going out to a fancy steak dinner, and his image of fancy is Carl's Jr.
Yes. And it's all to promote this steak sandwich. And what can you tell us about the sandwich besides what I put in my mouth here, which I've always been, just for so everybody understands, I've not only been a fan of Carl's Jr., I actually liked it so much. It's like the old TV commercial. I once bought the stock. I own the stock of the company for years. So I'm just a big fan. But tell us about the sandwich.
The sandwich is delicious. It's a charbroiled steak sandwich, 100% sirloin steak.
Yeah, it's got some breaded onion rings in there, some lettuce, mayo, tomato on a toasted steak roll.
It's got all the basic food groups covered.
You got
it's
it.
Everything
you
want. Now,
if you guys would introduce yourselves, tell us.
My name's Justin Hooper.
And I am Mick DeMaria, and we are the creative directors at Mendelsohn's Eye Advertising.
Oh, very nice. Yep. Do you make all the Carl's commercials?
We do, yeah. That's our job.
Fantastic.
It's a tough gig.
Well, they get attention. And let's talk a bit about those commercials for a second. You guys have gotten attention over the years. You've had hot chicks. You've had controversy. And it seems to me that because of the kind of audience that Carl's Jr. is going for, which is young, hungry guys, that you're not afraid to be a little edgy, which is good.
Exactly. I mean, our client knows, too. It's when you don't have a huge budget like some of these mega corporation fast food places, you got to make the biggest splash possible. So they understand you got to be bold. You need to make a big bang.
Absolutely. By the way, if you want to see the spots, and I've watched them repeatedly, you go to blowmeuptom.com, and you can see them right there. Blowmeuptom.com, we link you right through, and you can see there's a shorter version and a longer version. They're all there. It's, everything is there. There's various cuts of the spot, I believe.
Yes, there is.
So, now, it's interesting because I think of Carl's Jr., I think of burgers. And, of course, there's other items at Carl's Jr., but steak sandwich is kind of a different thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it's all about, like, premium products, basically. It's like we're trying to get the best products for the money. And, you know, you were talking about value before, and, you know, you got to cut back in your life, but you can't cut back on food. And you're always going to want something good to eat, you know, and we provide that, so.
Yeah, it's the perfect budget date night for any guy.
Well, if you can pull through a drive-through window and get a steak, that's pretty good.
Yeah, exactly.
That's right. I mean,
need some wine.
It's like us 101, baby.
Absolutely right.
It's a cheap date.
Absolutely right. Now, you guys have become notorious at Carl's Jr. Because, well, for example, there's that famous quote by Jay Leno saying that you guys use meat as a condiment.
We're very proud of that.
And I say, what's wrong with that?
It sounds good. I mean, who else is he talking about on his monologue? So, I mean, it's obviously getting some attention. We're talking about it.
I think it's funny that people, I gotta tell you, I'm a fast food freak, and I love the fast food places, and SoCal is where fast food originated. Drive-through everything originated here, and fast food originated here. Carl's Jr. is one chain that originated
sure.
right here in Anaheim. It was originally just a SoCal thing. And now it's spread out all over the place. But what is fascinating to me is that there are people who they just don't get it. Young guys want a big, heavy, meaty meal. That's what they want. That's it. It is not. They're not looking for fruit salad. They're not looking for yogurt. They're not looking for a salad bar. Forget it. So Carl's Jr. gets it, and that's why I've always been a big fan. That's why I'm happy to have you guys in. Thank you so much
for
coming
in. Too.
Thank you, Tom. We love you.
Absolutely. Tamara, you were great in the spot, by the way. Fantastic. Thank you.
Thank you.
Tamara Brown and her friends over here from the ad agency and the folks from Carl's Jr. It's the charbroiled steak sandwich. You can actually go through the drive-thru. You can actually get a steak sandwich. You can get it's like a steak in there. You can hold it in your hand and just chow down. As I'm doing right now. No, our email address is my name. It's tom@blowmeuptom.com. tom@blowmeuptom.com. You know, our show's on 6 days a week now. If you don't live in SoCal, you'd like to hear the Saturday edition of the Tom Likas Show between 2 and 6 p.m., go to blowmeuptom.com. Click on the Listen Live button between 2 and 6 p.m. Pacific Time, and you'll be listening live.
The Tom Likas Show.